whatever. I don't know there. So I don't really. I'm speaking about Mayavadi Advaita and Gitas and stuff, but I don't. Basically, we should avoid those things. Mahabhu tells, and Auntie Leela, Mayavadi Bhashya Shunile Haya Sarvanash. He's instructing Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya that he says, Mayavadi Bhashya. Bhashya means words, language. The Bhashya, rather, because like we say, Brajbhash. Bhash means words, language, and dialect, but it also means a commentary. So there's a Vedanta Sutra. Shankar wrote a commentary to kind of fluff out and explain the Vedanta Sutras, and he titled it Mayavadi Bhashya. This is the opinion, this is the language, these are the words or conclusions of the Mayavadis, and he's the leader, Shankar, Shankaracharya. So then what did we write? What is our commentary on Vedanta Sutras? Govinda Bhashya. So Govinda Bhashya. So Mayavadi Bhashya is the words and language of the Mayavadi, and the main Mayavadi is, and the origin of the Mayavad philosophy is Adi Shankaracharya. So Lord Chaitanya said, don't listen to this, because if you listen to this, everything is destroyed. Sarvanash. Sarvanash. Mayavadi Bhashya Shunile Haya Sarvanash becomes. Haya means becomes. Everything becomes destroyed by Shunile hearing these kind of ananda this, ananda that in Bhagavad Gita. We shouldn't do that. We'll lose everything. So those that are very familiar with Sanskrit, they can drive so many different meanings. And in your question you say, generally it's translated, it means that the Guru is always offering Krishna four kinds of delicious food. Chatravida, Sri Bhagavat Prasad, Swadana Chittan Hari Bhakta Sangan. And then, I mean, the translation we see in front of us here, translate this verse, Chaturvita Shri Bhagavat Prasad, Swadana Triptan Hari Bhakta Sangan, Kritveva Triptim Bhajatak Sadeva, Bande Guru Shri Charanaravindam. The spiritual master, Shri Guru, is always offering Krishna four kinds of delicious food. The four kinds means food, some foods that you lick, some foods you chew, some foods you drink, they're drinks and liquids, and some you suck, like a chosha mango. You squeeze it all, squeeze it, then cut the end off it, and squeeze out the little poison first comes out, then you squeeze it and suck on the mango. So that's called sucking the mango. When the Guru sees that devotees are satisfied eating Bhagavat Prasadam, he is satisfied. I offer respectful obeisances unto such a spiritual master. The devotee is asking the question, is this verse only talking about the guru offering bhog, the Thakurji, and then distributing prasad? Or does it have a larger or deeper metaphorical meaning that it means that the guru is what? Nam Rupa Guna Leela. The guru is offering Krishna the Nam Rupa Guna Leela. Then he's distributing that Nam Rupa Guna Leela to others, and he becomes very satisfied. I haven't heard that nor read that explanation. And I was just saying that the experts in Sanskrit, they can see all kinds of meanings. So I don't know Sanskrit, so I can't say whether that meaning is there or not. And I gave the example of Divya Chakshush and the Bhagavad Gita. Everyone says this darshan of Virata Rupa, Arjuna received transcendental eyes, Divya Chakshus. So he could see that Krishna is actually Virata Rupa. But our Gaudiya Rasik Acharyas, they say, actually, because the general Aishwarya Bhaktas, the Aishwarya Mayi Bhaktas, Vaishnavas, they have concluded. Someone will say, how do you know that Krishna is God? Oh, Krishna showed the universal form. Can your Sai Baba show the universal form?